Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about when to shift gears in order to maximize acceleration. And so really what we're doing is our goal is to maximize the force of the driven wheels on the ground across, you know, any speed, any RPM, whatever gear we're in. We want that force to be as large as possible as we're accelerating. So here we have a beautiful blue Honda S2000. That was very obvious just from looking at the sketch. And so we're trying to maximize this force here. Now, two of the assumptions that we're going to make, we're going to assume that we have infinite traction, so we don't have to worry about that as far as gearing is concerned, and we're also going to be assuming we're driving in a straight line. So there could be tracks where, for example, you're going around a corner and it may not be beneficial to upshift and then downshift again. Maybe beneficial to just leave it in gear. We're going to ignore that. We're just going in a straight line. We want to know when is the best time to shift gears based on RPM and your gearing. So, in order to maximize this force at the wheels, we want our torque at the wheels, obviously, to be as large as possible. So your engine sends torque back, it goes through the transmission, hits the rear differential, comes to your wheels. You want that torque at the wheels to be as large as possible. That torque at the wheels is equal to the force that it's applying, multiplied by the radius of that tire. So, now that we're kind of changing this from our goal is to maximize wheel force, we're going to change that goal to maximizing wheel torque because they're going to accomplish the same thing. We'll get maximum acceleration when we have maximum wheel torque, which gives us our maximum wheel force. So, we need to know what is the equation for the torque at the wheels. Within the equation for the torque at the wheels, we have our engine torque. We're going to multiply that by the gear ratio of whatever gear we are in. We're going to multiply that by our final drive ratio, and that could also be multiplied by other gear reductions. For example, in the Honda S2000, there is another gear reduction in the transmission before it gets to the final drive, and then you will, of course, multiply that by any losses that you have through the transmission. Now, the losses will, of course, apply to every gear, and the final drive ratio and the gear reduction are constant. So we're just gonna ignore these because these aren't really gonna change with each gear. Our variables here are the engine torque, which of course depends on RPM, and our gear ratio, which just depends on which gear you've put it in. So we're gonna assume maximum engine torque with the throttle wide open. So moving on, we want to maximize this number right here multiplied together. Engine torque times gear ratio, we want that as big as possible, always, and that's going to give us our highest wheel torque. So looking at the Honda S2000's gear ratios, here I have them 1 through 6. It's a 6-speed manual transmission. And so our gears here we have, so for example, 3.133 in first gear versus 2.045 in second gear. So what that means, if you take 3.133 and divide it by 2.045, there's a 53% difference there. So you're gonna have 53% more wheel torque in first gear at the same engine RPM as you would in second gear. What that, of course, the drawback to that is you don't have as high of a top speed. So second gear will go to a higher speed with less wheel torque. First gear will go to a lower speed with more wheel torque. So in order for this, in order for you to shift, the torque from the engine has to drop. Let's say we're going from first to second gear, the torque from the engine would have to drop 53% in order for that to be worthwhile, which is going to be very rare, as you might imagine. So you're pretty much going to run that out to redline. So let's look now at a dyno curve so we can now get the exact numbers and know, you know, what should we do, when should we shift gears, depending on which gear shift we're on. So this, I just Googled Honda S2000. Ideally, you would want to dyno your vehicle, which I will do eventually, but ideally you're going to want to dyno your vehicle, that way you can get the exact numbers, but you can just Google it, get something very close. I Googled S2000 dyno sheet, this is a 2002, and it was a stock vehicle, so very close to what I might find on my own. Basically what you've got, nice flat torque curve up until about 6,000 RPM, then VTEC changes it to a different cam profile, and you get to a higher, you know, about 130 pound-feet here. And then, of course, as you get to the higher RPMs, that power starts to taper off. And so, basically, what we're gonna look at is this tapering off of the torque, when should we shift in this tapering in order to get back into this peak torque? So our example, we're gonna be in third gear, we're gonna be going flat out, and we're gonna wanna know, you know, should we have shifted at 8,800 RPM, which is redline. So we're gonna shift to 8,800 RPM, and then we're gonna do the math and decide whether or not that was a good idea. So in third gear, we have a gear ratio of 1.481. In fourth gear, when we shift, we have a gear ratio of 1.161. So we're at 8,800 RPM in third. We want to figure out what RPM that will be in fourth. So we just do this simple ratio, multiply 8,800 by 1.161, divide that by 1.481, and that gives us about 6,900 RPM. Okay, so now what we want to find out is what is the wheel torque in each one of these gears at this exact moment. So in third gear, when we're at 8,800 RPM, you can see we're making 110 pound-feet. So 1.481, which is our gear ratio, multiplied by the engine torque, which is 110 pound-feet, gives us 163 pound-feet. Now in fourth gear, with a gear ratio of 1.161, we are going to be at 6,900 RPM. So that's going to be somewhere in this range right here. As you can see, that's going to be about 130 pound-feet. So we'll put in 130 pound-feet right there, multiply that across, and that gives us about 151 pound-feet. So as you can see, 163 is higher than 151. So what that means is in third gear at 8,800 RPM, we were putting down more wheel torque than when we shift down to fourth, even though we're now at peak engine RPM. Because of the gear reduction, we're putting down less torque at the wheels, so it was a smart decision to shift at redline. Now, the idea of shifting at redline is actually going to apply to every single gear in my Honda S2000. So if you look at 130 and you divide that by 110, so that's our peak, that's this nice flat area, you divide that by 110, that gives us about 18% difference. And as you can see from each one of these gears here, 18% is less of a gear reduction or a torque disadvantage than changing gears in any of these. So what that means is basically run it out to redline and then shift gears. And that's going to be the case for, you know, tons of vehicles out there, especially for your initial gears 1 through 3, where there's a bigger split between the gear ratios. You know, it could get different once you get down into these, but basically for most cars out there, it's going to be the case where you're going to want to just run it right out to redline. You can do the math yourself and kind of figure it out, but for most vehicles out there, because of the gearing advantage of the lower gears, it's going to be beneficial, even if torque starts to fall off, to stay in that lower gear until you do actually hit redline and then shift gears and get back into that peak engine torque, but less wheel torque. Now, a great resource, this book, Physics for Gearheads. I will include a link in the video description. I've mentioned this before. It is a really cool book if you're into this kind of thing. They do a very similar problem with the Corvette. They used a bit different methodology, but anyways, they did the same thing. And they found also that even for this Corvette Z06 2008, you want to go to redline every single time, gears 1 through 5, before shifting in order to get maximum acceleration. So it generally will be the case that you'll just pretty much go out to redline. So when would it not be ideal to shift at redline? Well, basically, it would be when this number right here is equal for each gear. So let's say you were in third gear at 8,500 RPM, and we're in the S2000, and we're making 102 pound-feet. Well, at that point, it's about equal to being in fourth gear with a gear reduction with 130 pound-feet. Now, this is less than we have here, but this makes the example work. So if you were at 8,500 RPM, and this was your wheel torque, or your engine torque rather, what you want to know is that, you know, if you keep going past that, your engine torque goes down, and as a result, you're going to be putting less wheel torque down than if you were to shift into fourth. So this doesn't happen in my car, but it is the case where, you know, it would be ideal to shift before redline if something like this happened and you were going for maximum acceleration. So thank you guys for watching, and if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below.